Yo, what's up? I'm back. I just did another video, which you might have seen, but yeah, otherwise it's been a few weeks actually since I've done any videos on here, and a few weeks since I've listened to any Taylor Swift whatsoever. But I'm picking up where I left off, and now I'm listening to The Last Great American Dynasty. So, if you're new here, or if this is the first of my videos you're seeing, I'm kind of digging into Taylor Swift, because I believe that she's an artist. That probably has really good music out there. But typically the stuff that might make it to the radio is probably not like an example of her best work. So yeah, she's an interesting example because obviously like a really talented and successful artist, but a lot of her most popular work is probably not representative of what her more dedicated fans might think of her music or think of her work. So obviously I'm sure some fans really hate how other people view Taylor Swift. And maybe that's one of the reasons, because her pop music, which is most popular, doesn't really represent her. So it's like, I get that. People develop an idea about somebody that is really only like very, one-sided. So I'm kind of taking the, I'm going through the trouble to actually dig through some of her work, and she has a lot of stuff out there by now. She's been an active musician for quite some time, so obviously I don't have like a full perspective on her entire catalog. But I'm going through it, and it's cool to share that journey with you guys, and sometimes get absolutely chewed the fuck out because I'm gonna have an honest reaction here. I'm more often surprised than not if there is something from Taylor Swift that I really enjoy and that really like kind of stimulates me on a musical level. But every now and then she kind of hits those notes, so to speak. And a couple of albums on this, or a couple songs on this album definitely have. So yeah, and even so, some of her like cheesier pop songs still kind of, are at least like a guilty pleasure for me sometimes. And if they are, I have no shame in admitting that. But if I don't like something, I'm gonna let you know because we keep it 100 here. That's what we do. All right, let's see what I think of The Last Great American Dynasty.
Rebecca rode up on the afternoon train. It was sunny.
It's funny, before Taylor's voice came in, the music was kind of quick to remind me of some work by the Postal Service. I'm wondering how many of you guys coming from, just being Taylor Swift fans would know about the Postal Service or not. I think they only had one album. The Postal Service eventually kind of turned into Death Cab for Cutie, which was definitely a bigger band. But quite a few people know the Postal Service as well. So if you ever, yeah, if you ever wanted to, go ahead and check some of their stuff out, I guess. And you'll see at least what I'm talking about a little bit.
Salt box house on the coast took a mind off St. Louis. Bill was the heir to the Standard Oil name and money. And the town said, how did a middle class divorce they do it? The wedding was charming, if a little gauche. There's only so far new money goes. They picked out a home and called it Holiday House. Their parties were tasteful, if a little loud. The doctor had told him to settle down. It must have been her fault his heart gave out. And they said,
I have a feeling that this song's already going to be one of the ones I like better on the album. It's not super weird like that, like The Lakes was. That song definitely really caught me off guard. Yeah, I guess I'm more into this idea already for different reasons.
there goes the last great American dynasty. Who knows if she never showed up, what could have been? There goes the maddest woman this town has ever seen. She had a marvelous time ruining everything.
She had a marvelous time ruining everything. That's funny.
Rebecca gave up on the Rhode Island set forever.
I I wonder if this picture in the background is from Rhode Island or not. I was wondering where this is from. It could be, right? Kind of looks like what I imagined some little beach slash lighthouse thing in Rhode Island to look like. Somebody let me know. I have this one person that comments. And you know who you are, I bet. You know who you are if you're watching these videos. I bet you'd know exactly where this picture is. Anyway.
Flew in all the bitch pack friends from the city. Filled the pool with champagne.
What the hell was bitch pack? Capitalized like it's a proper noun? What the fuck is bitch pack friends? What? It's all capitalized like it's a proper noun or something. What the hell? I mean, maybe it is for this song in a way, like kind of in an artistic way. What the hell's bitch pack? I am Googling this right now. Oh, what the fuck? Okay. Urban Dictionary, which isn't always the most credible source of information, says a group of girls or clique that is controlled by the alpha bitch, who is the hottest and biggest bitch of them all. I'm seeing some other stuff too that's kind of painting the picture a little bit about what the bitch pack is. Okay. All right. I have an idea.
From the city. Filled the pool with champagne and swam with the big names and blew through the money on the boys and the valet. And losing on card game bets with Dolly. And they said they're...
What is Dolly? The only Dolly I know of is like Dalai Lama. Jesus. Someone else is going to have to come in and you know, sort of fill in the gaps. Huh. If I type in Dolly gambling, does anything come up? No. Jeez. Salvador Dali. I mean, maybe, huh? Maybe that's what it is. Salvador Dali. That's my only other guess. Spanish artist, lived from 1904 to 1989. Yeah, geez, you guys are gonna have to let me know. I feel like I'm kind of shooting in the dark here, trying to figure out what the hell that means. Yeah, somebody fill me in if you have any idea who that is exactly.
Beds with Dolly, and they said, there goes the last great American dynasty. Who knows if she never showed up, what could have been? There goes the most shameless woman this town has ever seen. She had a marvelous time ruining everything. They say she was seen on occasion pacing the rocks, staring out at the midnight sea. And in a feud with her neighbor, she stole his dog and dyed it key lime green. 50 years is a long time. Holiday house side, quietly on that beach. Free of women with madness, the men. If I never showed up, what could have been? There goes the loudest woman this town has ever seen. I had a marvelous time ruining everything. I had a marvelous time ruining everything. A marvelous time.
I don't know why, but somehow her kind of switching the perspective around after she bought the house or something kind of took away something from the song for me. Not exactly sure why. Yeah, musically, lyrically, kind of a cool song. I like how the story developed. There's some cool lines in there. Just something about that little perspective shift at the end. I don't know why I don't really care for that. I mean, is she supposed to be this person all along? She's not, right? Because then she bought the house, and then she had a marvelous time reading everything. I don't know. I feel like the story kind of falls apart there a little bit. Because I feel like chronologically it doesn't quite work to say that the way that she did and then just sort of repeat that chorus again. I don't know. It seems like kind of a lazy shift of perspective, actually. But maybe I'm missing something. I don't know. It is unusually early, actually, for me to be doing one of these videos. Typically, I do it at like 3 in the morning or some stupid hour like that. When I'm between things that I should be doing. But now it's pretty early in the morning at like a normal hour. What is it, like 10:30 right now? My sleep schedule's all over, you guys. But yeah, still kind of a cool song. Honestly, I might have to listen to that one again sometime and really see what I think for myself. But yeah, that's my first impression anyway. Okay. I'm going to listen to one more Taylor Swift song off of this album, and then I'll see if I feel like doing more. But, yeah, thanks for watching. Let me know if you have some other songs by her that you'd like me to check out. I'll try to get to them. And I guess I'll see you guys in a future video. All right. Well, I will see you there if you're there. Until then, take care. Bye.